Hello everyone, we will discuss in this setting vitamin B for children. We will start by simple classification of vitamins. As you know, there is two main categories: fat soluble vitamins, which make letters of the word AKID, vitamin A, vitamin K, vitamin D, vitamin E, which needs fatty media for its absorption. And water-soluble vitamins which we discuss today: thiamine, vitamin B1, riboflavin, vitamin B2, niacin, vitamin B3, pyridoxine, vitamin B4, biotin, vitamin B6, folic acid, cobalamin, ascorbic acid, this vitamin C, and bentothenic acid. This is a more detailed classification and beneficial in fact. So vitamins are fat soluble and water soluble. B complex and non B complex. Non B complex including of course vitamin C, and the B complex classified here an interesting classification, which is hematopoietic, folic acid, and vitamin B12. These are stimulate the blood to produce more erythrocytes or RBCs, and energy releasing, which are vitamin B1, B2, B3, biotin, and bentothenic acid. Others are like pyridoxine, vitamin B6, pyridoxal, pyridoxamine. Okay. Some facts about vitamin B. They are made up of 8 chemically distinct and water-soluble vitamins that once were thought to be one vitamin, known as vitamin B complex. This name now is not of too much importance in the medical fields. Must be replenished daily as they are not stored in the body. No stores for vitamin B. They are obtained from different food sources. Okay. Vitamin B complex is the old name, vitamin B group is a new name, made up of 8 chemically and distinct materials or vitamins, water soluble and vitamins that once were thought to be one, as we just said. Functions: at times all of the vitamin B work together to keep the body functioning in a healthy manner. So they are working together. They are needed for the following. Okay, here classified by color for proper functioning of body metabolic system, converting carbohydrate and glucose. So this golden or beige are for metabolism, promoting cell growth, reproduction, and division. DNA and RNA synthesis. These are for synthesis and growth. Protecting body from cardiovascular diseases, strengthening the immune system, maintaining and enhancing the function of the nervous system, helping the digestive system to work properly. This slide will actually show the importance of vitamin B. These four last items for wide range of body systems is cardiovascular and immune, and the nervous system and the digestive system actually. Then maintaining healthy muscle tone and skin, reducing risk of certain types of cancer, especially pancreatic cancer, which is evident recently by use of vitamin. Lastly, fighting depression and anxiety and stress for psychiatric purpose, and improving memory. Brain use vitamin B6 to increase serotonin level. Here also a diagram showing its effect on the nervous system, digestive system, muscle, and protecting against pancreatic cancer. Also fighting depression and enhancing memory. This doctor and scientist actually named Christian Eijkman, which was in the 19th century. This one who discovered the role of vitamin for immunity and preventing diseases. He actually made a very interesting experiment and very simple. He brought two healthy chickens and offered for them unpolished rice. This means white rice with the outer cover or the vitamin B layer. And accompanied with them a sick hen, one chicken who was ill. A sick chicken from institute and two healthy chickens. After eating this unpolished rice by 2 weeks, all become healthy, even the sick one. This group number one. On the other hand, these four healthy chicken offered polished rice without this cover or vitamin layer. They become sick after 2 to 3 weeks. Healthy chicken here become fed and became sick. This is the second group. This is the control group, which offered unpolished rice and become the same. And the final one is the same, unpolished rice after 2 weeks, like a control group. Nothing happened with them. What's the difference between the control group and the fourth group? Is this group injected with bacteria. So they become sick iatrogenically for experiment. But being eating this this rice, the unpolished rice, protects them from infection. Okay, we'll start with vitamin B1, thiamine, a biological active form and function, a cofactor in metabolism, oxidative decarboxylation, and so on. Sources, pork, whole grains, legumes. Recommended daily dose, 0.5 mg per 1000 calorie or 1 kilocalorie. Deficiency, decrease ATP production because this is energy producing or promoting vitamin. Impaired cellular function as it enter in this oxidative decarboxylation. And beriberi. This beriberi was famous in the last century, which called Wernicke syndrome and edema and heart failure, food drop, and loss of deep reflexes and paresthesia, loss of sensation, and so on. This x-ray showing heart failure for this patient. But it's also present, but to some extent rare. Present in childhood by edema and swelling of legs and tachypnea, increased respiratory rate. This is a very interesting phenomena. This girl actually was in Tel Aviv hospital, who her grandmother gave her a thiamine free formula, thiamine B1 free formula by mistake for 1 or 2 years. So they found that this girl suffered from very serious illness and was a disastrous end. Motor function severely affected, motor function and cognitive behavior before the school age. So they found that thiamine deficiency, as we see here, this is thiamine present in all milk formula. So she, by mistake, used a free thiamine formula. They discovered that this vitamin is very important for cognitive and mental capabilities and development. Here, this in Spanish language. This thiamine B, thiamina, for it is essential for central nervous system, as we mentioned. Requirementus 0.4 milligram per 1000 from food sources. This higado means liver, carne de cerdo and the cereals, cereals also, and fish and everything. It is denaturalized by cooking and heating. Okay. This is the second vitamin, riboflavin, B2. B2, biological active form, flavin, mono, FAD and NAD and FMN, function electron transfer. It is very important in biochemical pathways of intracellular chemical processes. Needed for good vision and healthy skin. And sources milk, mushroom, tomatoes, liver, green. Deficiency would lead to gross retardation, inflammation of the tongue, glossitis, and stomatitis, inflammation of mouth and lips. if vitaminosis complete, absence of vitamin B12 is very rare. Very rare, but manifests itself as photophobia, conjunctivitis, glossitis, and so on. Riboflavin work also with other groups for healthy skin and important, very important for energy and electron transfer. For niacin, the third vitamin B3, it is also important for NAD and NADB. And sources, unrefined grains, which are unpolished, fortified cereals, meat, fish, tomato, as we see in this photo. Requirement, about 6 mg per 1000 kilocalorie. Here, per 1000 kilocalorie, as this is an energizer vitamin. And food sources, actually, from fat, meat, fish, nuts, bread, and also cooking, too much cooking denaturalize the vitamin. Vitamin B3 deficiency will lead to this pellagra, which is exfoliation and dermatitis of the palm of the hand together with the face. It is also rare nowadays, and the mental symptoms. For pyridoxin, its importance actually come from its efficacy, because deficiency will lead to dermatitis and seizures and convulsion and headache, microcytic hypochromic anemia, because it is one not of the energetic vitamin as the mentioned before. This is the first one, hematopoietic vitamin, together with folic acid, as we'll mention in the next one. It is hematopoietic and neurological, neurotropic one. Okay. Lead to fatigue and seizures. From this, you will find it. It's very important for erythropoiesis, and its absence will lead to dizziness and migraine. Even some experiments use it to relieve migraine, but its blood or serum level was normal. But it gave very useful results, actually. Not in all types of migraine, but in selective types. Also, too much vitamin D will lead to nerve damage, paresthesia of arms and leg. But this neuropathy is correctable with control of intake of vitamin B6. Vitamin B7, actually, this is, I used to call it, this one for beauty. As you see, it stimulates hair growth and used as shampoo and hair tonics and so on. But it is synthesized by intestinal bacteria, so it is present in very rare to be find deficient. So it's a requirement 30 mg per day. If deficient, this by wrong food habits, feeding habits. Deficiency does not occur naturally unless someone eat 20 raw eggs whites per day, because this protein avidine binds to biotin irreversibly and excreted and so on. Function also regulation of gene expression, and very important as energetic vitamin. Sources also besides this bacteria, egg yolk, tomato, almond, milk, and peanuts, avocado, mushroom also. For the next vitamin, folic acid, this is one of the very important vitamins, and its absence is disastrous to the fetus, mainly to swelling in the neural tube, and making hydrocephalus and meningocele, and as you see, this is the most deficient points. So it is recommended and now mandatory for pregnant women. Also, folic acid is present in green leafy veggies, as you see, and nuts and legumes, whole grains. Requirement, actually, 400, this is the most powerful one for blood and neurological tube, as we mentioned. So it is needed about half a gram daily during pregnancy and lactation. Deficiency will lead to also the famous megaloblastic or macrocytic anemia and the growth failure. May lead to abortion, and so it is very important. Function stimulate also the appetite, used as appetizer. These are the sources of vitamin B12, which would be the last vitamin to discuss in this family. as shrimps and the tuna and the egg yolk, also mushroom, and the richest source is dairy products after liver. This vitamin B12 is called actually cobalamin. It will lead to pernicious anemia and degeneration of the CNS or neurological degeneration, lead to hypotonia, convulsions, and mental retardation, disabilities, and normocytic or macrocytic anemia. Okay, so it, now recent studies show its role in behavioral problems, especially in autistic spectrum and falling behind at school. This requirement is very low, 2.4 mg per day. This also one picture of pernicious anemia due to lack of deficiency factor in the parietal layer of the stomach, and sometimes for this gastrectomy and operation produce pernicious anemia. Pernicious anemia not for only for the elderly but also for pediatric age group. It is called juvenile pernicious anemia, less than 10 years of age. This is a supplement of vitamin B12, it, either injection if there is no intrinsic factor as we see, or orally if there is intrinsic factor in the stomach. I thank you for your listening. Goodbye.